Hey there, and welcome to this Dollmotion Christmas special. In this video, we're going to make Krampus. For those who don't know who Krampus is, Krampus is a half-demon, half-goat-beast man who is the companion of Saint Nicholas around Christmas time. It's an old tradition to have Krampus parades and to tell children they better behave, otherwise Krampus will get them in the night. My Christmas special from 2 years ago was also a doll costume inspired by Krampus. But I got more experience on doll modifications and repaints, so I'm actually want to see if I have improved in 2 years' time. So let's begin and remake Krampus! If you saw the bell and chain in my previous repaint video, then you found the hint. Good luck find the hint in this video! For this art doll costume, I'm going to use this Spectre head and this Hunter Huntsman body. Yeah, his head went to Eland Alchies, and Spectre's body went to the Decoracay bunny. I'm kinda running out on male doll heads, so Spectre will be getting a few face modifications in the end. But first, let's prep the doll head. I cut the hair as close to the head as possible. I go through the neck opening with tweezers and remove the remaining hairs. With pure acetone, I remove the factory painted face. And yeah, these also need to go. Just like my first Krampus doll, this Krampus will also get a lot of body modifications. First, I need to replace the Ever After High boy neck pack with a Monster High neck pack. Otherwise, Spectre's head won't fit. Also, the rest of the doll body will be sawed in pieces, with emphasis on doll body. Otherwise, this would be a very creepy sentence. Good, the doll body is in pieces. I got a few extra parts from the Monster High boy body, like a neck pack and knee joints. Just like Sly for the Sky Dragon, I want my Krampus to have an extra digi-grade leg joint. But before I reconstruct the body, let's give him a few holes on his back and one for his tail. As a simple filling material, I'm going to use air drying foam and holding everything together using bandage tape. These sticks will be bones growing out of his back. I don't know why, but my first Krampus also had it, and it looks pretty cool. The Spectre head can be placed on the neck pack, but not before she gets a Joker slit. Also, don't forget to heat up the neck opening when placing a female head on a boy neck pack. Otherwise, it won't fit. Now for the famous Krampus horns. I make incisions in the head and slide a wire through the mouth. The wire will form the horns, but will also keep the mouth open. With super glue, I place a pre-made tail in the hole I made earlier. I want my Krampus to have creepy long, claw-like fingers. To do this, I first need to shorten his human fingers, so I can replace them with a wire armature. Now I can finally secure all the attachments with a two-part epoxy glue. While they stick, I simply spread the glue around the attachments. Yeah, he's basically a sandwich at this point. And now we're at the point I like to call the nightmare fuel stage. As you can see, Krampus has a long curved neck, a curved back and digitigrade legs with an extra joint. Also, his feet were trimmed to make it easier to form them into hooves. To form all the body modifications, I'm going to use epoxy sculpt. Don't forget to use gloves when handling this stuff, because you'll probably get a bad rash when handling this with bare hands. I can speak out of experience. Because epoxy sculpt air dries over time, you won't have that much time to sculpt your project, so it's better to work with multiple layers. This is layer 1. And this is layer 2. I got very inspired by the more devilish appearance of Krampus, like in the old drawings and photographs. After a day of air drying, the epoxy sculpt is ready to be sand. For this, I'll be using my Dremel and a sanding block. Hanging from his tail, I sprayed the whole doll in one color using a spray can from the brand Liquitex. His legs will be getting a color transition, so the undercoat will be a light brown. Using a bony white color, I paint in his hooves, horns and teeth. And now that I'm painting in his face in the background, let's answer a few questions of the day, as a Christmas tradition. How long does it take to make the Divas series, and what program do you use? It takes a full week to make one episode, and I use DragonFrame to animate scenes. Was Penny found in the same forest as the statues? Yes, in the same forest. What animal do you want to make in the future? I like to make a sloth, platypus, duck, more wolves, and a llama would be fun to make a doll for. Are the Bird Divas characters hatched from eggs or born naturally? They are hatched from eggs. What's your favorite holiday tradition? Watching movies from the 80s with Bart. Why do you never show your face? You can find a picture of me in the YouTube community tab. Are you gonna make a whole video speaking Dutch? Ik heb geen plannen om een video in het Nederlands te doen. Can we make our own characters in the same style universe as the Divas? Yes, you can take inspiration from the Divas universe. You can make your own original characters or dolls and use my characters in fan art. But please not for commercial use. Do you have a question of the day? Please leave it in the comment section and maybe I will answer it in the next repaint video. Back to the face-up. To seal on the face-up, I sprayed the whole doll's head a few times with the toxic Mist Super Clear. Krampus is still pretty hairless at this point, so let's change that with some yarn. I knotted to a giant cut-off fly swatter and start combing out the yarn. Now I'm going to cut the yarn in teeny tiny pieces to make fluff. I'm going to use this homemade fluff for his ears, upper hands and tail. For the rest of his body, I made yarn wefts, which I'm going to glue on using a hot glue gun. It looks very difficult, but just begin with the limbs and go around the torso to the head. When we reach the head, we want to make a nice transition from weft to face. We do this with some fabric glue and loose yarn wefts. And some pastel powders to make the transition complete. Unlike all my male characters, he's getting two bushy eyebrows. Because this Krampus is a remake, he will be cutting a Santa outfit made out of a Christmas hat. For the bells and chains, I'm going fully gold this time. And with this, the Christmas art doll is done. I'm very happy I made the Santa outfit removable this time. So I can also display him like a traditional Krampus. Which one do you like better, the old Krampus or the new Krampus? To be honest, 2019 was a difficult year for Dollmotion. Changing YouTube algorithms that don't work for this channel. And of course the whole FTC issue. All that stress and sleepless nights. Although the situation looks kind of better now. But are we saved and is it fully fixed? Yes and no. The situation is still very unclear. And we really need to see what will happen in January 2020. So my next repaint video will go to Patreon. And the Divas episodes will be uploaded to YouTube like I promised. But I have plans to upload repaint videos again to YouTube starting February or March. So watch the upcoming Divas episodes to see which character. You may have missed it, probably not. My Patreon page has two new videos. You can watch a repaint video with young versions of Volpini, Alex and Felicia with a pre-Divas Volpini. And a flashback Divas episode about Pyrrhus dealing with family issues. Very Christmassy. Speaking of Patreon, I want to thank my supporters. Chelsea Panda Monkey, Amethyst Drake, Art Weasel Customs, Erica Warren, The Oreo Jedi, Crazy Girl 57, Nikki Boyle, Erica Lehner, and other Patreons for helping me through the stressful COPA FTC situation. Really, thank you so much everyone. I'm really happy Dollmotion will continue in 2020 with Divas episodes and repaints. Man, I have so many awesome dolls planned for you. And the Divas series will be getting a lot of adventure, mystery and romance. To end this video with a lot of Christmas vibe, over 60 people on Instagram joined Draw This In Your Own Style Christmas Edition Challenge. Thank you so much everyone who joined. Seeing Alex in so many different art styles is just amazing. I wish you a wonderful Christmas and a happy new year. And like always, like if you liked it and sub if you loved it. And I will see you in 2020. Bye!